Planet Dolan.
What superhero defeats his enemies by throwing his stomach at them? How can an inanimate piece of pavement be a superhero? From parody characters to obscure original ones, here are 15 of the strangest superheroes ever written into a comic book. Hey there, I'm Hellbent. I'm here to learn you suspiciously amazing facts that I didn't just make up. Number 15. We start our trip through weird superhero land with a look at a guy who eats things. Tenzel Kim, better known as Matter Eater Lad, grew up on the toxic planet of Bismol, where people had to learn to eat anything and everything as a survival mechanism. So, that's his power. He can eat anything. Later, he ended up becoming a chef. This guy is basically just Gergak. Number 14. Ashley Crawford is a fashion model from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, who happens to have mutant superpowers. Her power is to selectively manipulate her body mass, becoming Big Bertha. And what that means is that she can make herself extremely fat to the point of being basically invulnerable. Think of it like if you had a beautiful model that could expand into the juggernaut. Number 13. You would think that upon reading a name like the Dog Welder that it couldn't possibly be what it sounds like. You would think that, and you would be wrong. Dog Welder is a hero, in a manner of speaking, who never speaks and is possibly psychotic. His power is dog welding. What that means is that he kills dogs, then welds those dogs to the bodies of his enemies, often to their faces. Number 12. Kid Eternity is a dead kid. Seriously, he was killed when a German U-boat sunk his grandfather's fishing boat, but it was 75 years too early. So, as an apology, he was brought back to life for another 75 years and given superpowers. When he says eternity, he can go invisible or immaterial, or he can summon the spirit of any historical figure. Number 11. Mogo is a member of the Green Lantern Corps, and that honestly makes him pretty important compared to some of these other heroes. But Mogo makes a list because it's a planet. Mogo is a sentient planet, which uses the powers of the Green Lantern to affect the conditions on its surface. It's kinda like Ego the Living Planet, but somehow even weirder. Number 10. Now we're going from a reasonably well-known Green Lantern-related character that you may have heard of to someone that you definitely haven't. Super DuPont is a French comic starring Jean DuPont, a character who both acts as a parody of Superman and as a parody of the stereotypical Frenchman. He fights the terrorist organization known as Anti-France, made up of foreigners who speak Anti-Francais. Think like Team America, but for France, and with a dash of Superman, and you've pretty much got it. Number 9. Infectious Lass applied to be a part of the Legion of Superheroes, but was turned down. See, her power is to infect people with diseases, but she can't really control it because it stems from colonies of microorganisms that are native to her people's bodies but toxic to most others. So she's just kind of contagious, or infectious, if you will. Number 8. Jamie Madrox is Multiple Man, a mutant in the X-Men universe who showed off his power from birth. When the doctor slapped his bottom, he created a duplicate of himself instantly. That's his power, to make multiples of himself. But his multiples aren't super strong or anything, so he's pretty much just a regular guy. Or a regular group of guys with a very specific goal. But he did have a pretty good scene in the otherwise terrible 2006 film X-Men The Last Stand. Number 7. Listen, Zeitgeist, yes, you got a cameo appearance in Deadpool 2, and yes, your name is cool, but let's be honest here, your power is puking on people. You can't go around pretending that's cool. Number 6. The Red Bee made his debut in 1940, and as such, he spent a lot of time fighting Nazis. Which, if you think about it, it's a weird thing for a district attorney from Oregon to do. But that's not really what's weird about the Red Bee. What's weird is that he had no real superpowers outside of the ability to train bees. He even named one of them Michael and keeps him in a special belt pouch. Number 5. You might think that Maggot is like the red bee, but like he controls maggots or flies instead of bees. But no, you'd be wrong, and shame on you for being so stupid. Maggot is way more disgusting than that. He's a mutant with a sentient digestive system. Where his stomach should be, there are a pair of slugs called Eenie and Meenie, which bore their way out of his body and devour things independently. Then they burrow back into his body and release the nutrients, giving Maggot super strength, speed, and size. Number 4. Brother Power the Geek is a character created in the late 1960s, and it shows. The entire series is deeply influenced by hippie subculture. He was a mannequin that came to life after being struck by lightning and was kidnapped by something called the Psychedelic Circus. The character only ran for 2 issues, but in that time, here are a few of the things that Brother Power the Geek got himself into. He ran for US Congress, got a job at the Acme Corporation, and was fired into space by then-California Governor Ronald Reagan. Number 3. Wondar the Aquarian is a Marvel Comics character whose origin story is that he was an alien on a distant planet. When his home planet was about to be destroyed, his parents placed him on a spaceship to save him. He landed on Earth, where he's found by an elderly couple, but they left his ship alone, fearing it might contain Martians, or worse, communists! When Wondar grew up, he donned a blue and red outfit and used his powers of super strength to fight against evil. That's right, Wondar is just a huge Superman parody slash homage slash ripoff. DC Comics accused author Steve Gerber of plagiarism, and Stan Lee even considered firing him from Marvel over the character. Ultimately, Wondar's appearance and powers were changed, and DC agreed to let Marvel keep using the character once they made him slightly less of a Superman ripoff. Number 2. Yes, his name is Arm Fall Off Boy, and yes, his power is that his arm indeed does fall off. Well, to be a bit more accurate, he rips his arm off and beats people to death with it. There's no real joke here, that's literally all he is. Even in the comic, people think it's weird. Number 1. Danny the Street sounds like he might be like a tough mob boss or something. Like Danny the Street and Jimmy the Kid to here to let you know the boss needs a favor. But that's not the case at all. Danny isn't a mob boss. He's a street. Like an actual street. He's a sentient piece of pavement. Danny has the ability to teleport into any cityscape without causing damage and generally creates a home for the downtrodden and ignored. In later stories, Danny becomes other things entirely. Danny the Alley, Danny the Ambulance, and eventually Danny the World. This video was made possible by our fans over on Patreon. Thanks for your support, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.